Good day, everyone. Welcome to lecture number 10 of Computer Programming in C. In our previous lectures, we discussed some of the fundamentals related to C. For example, we discussed data types, variables, constants, identifiers, keywords, and character set of C programming language. We have to discuss some other fundamental is related to C before starting writing the programs. However, before discussing those fundamentals, there are some important functions that are required in every C program or in every program. And those functions are to help us to perform input-output operations. So we will first discuss the functions that are used for performing input-output functions, because those functions are most commonly used in our programs. So we will discuss some of the functions here so that later on we can use those functions in our programs. So input-output here means in our C program, sometimes we have to display something, display anything, okay? Or we have to take input. Our program requires some input, okay? So the options for displaying something or displaying text or numbers or anything that we want to display, the different options where we can display our output from the C program. For example, we can display on the monitor. Monitor means output device. It is an output device, or we can say on screen. The second option is to display our output into some file. Okay. So we want to put some result in a file, some file. For example, this file is stored in our hard disk. Or sometimes we have to display our output on some port. So what is a port? And why we have to display something on the port, we will discuss it later on, because it is not the part of discussion at this particular level, because currently we are at the starting of C programming. So let's leave this port for some time. We will discuss about these ports in great detail in our subsequent lectures. So that means in our C program, we may have to display something on the monitor, or we have to write something in a file. Write something means write some output in the file, or write something in the port. Likewise, there is an option that we have to take input. Okay, take input from keyboard. For example, my program will say that give me an input. So one way is to give input using a keyboard. The other method is to give input using a file. So that means if my program requires some data, it will read that data from a file. And that file may be stored in, the same here, it may be stored in hard disk. Or we may have to take input. We here means our program may have to take input from a port. Okay. So that means my C program, or the C program that we want to execute, or we want to write a C program, and if I want something to be displayed on something, or I can say if I want that my computer program should provide some output, okay, output it can provide on a monitor, file, or port. Or if I want that my C program should take input from the users. So it can take input through a keyboard, through a file, or port. So for doing these input-output operations, my C program requires some functions. So it uses some functions. And those functions are called input-output functions. Input-output functions. So what is a function? Function is a block of statements, or we can say function is written like this. Function has some arguments. So these are its arguments. And arguments are separated by commas. Some function has one argument, two argument, three argument. There are different types of functions. And function is written, the statements of a function are written inside the opening and closing brace. Okay. So in our C programming, we have some functions, predefined functions. Means we have not defined those functions. They are already in our compiler. Okay, when we install a compiler, those functions get installed with our compiler. And we can use those functions whenever we want to perform an input-output operation. We can display, we can provide output from on a monitor, on a file or a port. Or we can take input from a keyboard, file or port using the functions that are predefined functions. Predefined functions. Okay, so that means in our C programming language, when we are installing a compiler, as I have already said, some libraries get installed with a compiler. Some libraries get installed. And there are hundreds of libraries that get installed. What is a library? Library is basically a file. It is a file that contains different functions. For example, it may contain some function. For example, function 1, function 2, function 3. And if I want to use some function from these libraries, I can use that function instead of writing my own function. So, for example, there is a library. The name of that library is math.h. Okay. So in this library, there is a function, sine function. So this function has been described in this library. Okay, sine. So let's say in my program, I have to find sine of 90 degree. Instead of defining my own function that calculates the sine of 90 degree, I can directly use this particular function. And this function is described in which library? Math.h. So that means I have to use this function in my program. So what I will do in my program, I will include this library in my program. So by including this library in my program, I am informing the compiler that I can use the functions that are described in this library. So I have to do hash include math.h. So here I have included which library? Math.h. So after including a library in my program, I can use all the functions that have been described in that particular library. However, if I didn't include this library in my program, I won't be able to use these functions that are already there in the libraries. Likewise, in our compiler, there is one library which is called studio.h. And another library is conio.h. So in these libraries, there are library functions, or we can say there are predefined functions that can be used to perform input-output operations. Okay, so what I am saying here that when we are installing a compiler, some libraries get installed, and there are two special libraries, which is studio.h and conio.h. In these libraries, there are already numerous, there are various different kinds of input-output functions define it. So that means if in my program I want to use an input output function, so I should include these particular library files in my program. And after including these library files in my program, I can use the functions that have been declared in these library files. Okay. So what I am saying here, so I said that in my C program, we have to perform output operation. Output means providing output on some device, or we have to do an input operation. Input means taking input from some entity. And for performing input and output operation, there are different IO functions that are already described in the libraries. And those libraries are studio.h and conio.h. And these libraries get installed, these libraries, when we install a compiler. Okay. And as I said, there are numerous input-output functions that have been defined in these two libraries. So we can directly use those input-output functions in our C program to perform input operation and output operation. And in today's lecture, we will discuss those functions and how they are used to output the data or take an input data. Okay. So what I said, that there are three options available. One option is provide output on the monitor and take input from the keyboard. The functions that are used to perform this input output. So what kind of input output? Providing output on the monitor and taking input from the keyboard. So for this, we are using input output operations, input output functions. Those functions are called console input output functions. What I am saying, so I will write down it here. So I said that there are three options. First, in both the cases, outputting the data or inputting the data. This first option is provide output on the monitor, or we can say screen. And here is take input from a keyboard. So the function is, I can say the output functions that are used to provide output on a screen and the input functions that are used to take input from keyboard. Those functions are called console input output functions. Console input output functions. The second option I said, that second option is to output data into a file or take input from the file. Or file, we can say hard disk. So these functions are called disk input output functions. So there are different functions to perform input and output like this, and there are different functions to perform input and output like this. And the third is providing output on a port or taking input from a port. And I already said that leave the port discussion for some time. We don't have to discuss it here. We will discuss it in our subsequent lectures. And the functions that are used to perform input output on ports are called port input output functions. In this particular lecture, in today's lecture, we will only discuss console input output functions. So disk input output functions and port input output functions, we will discuss these when we require these functions. For example, disk input output functions will be required when we discuss a file chapter in C programming, how to access files in C programming. Likewise, port input output functions will be discussed when we discuss the lecture related to ports in C program. So here only we will discuss only the input output functions that are console input output functions, or we can say the output functions that will provide output on a monitor, or input functions that take input from a keyboard. So here we will discuss only these functions. Let's start the discussion about these console input output functions. Console input output functions. We will first discuss the functions for outputting the data, and then we will discuss the functions for taking the input data. Okay, so first we will discuss output functions. Okay. And after completing output functions, we will discuss input functions. So output functions are those functions that are used in C programming language to output something on screen. Something, we will discuss what this something is on screen. Screen here means monitor. And input functions will be used to take input from keyboard. Okay, those functions that are used to take input from keyboard. And let's first discuss about the output functions. Okay. Output functions. So let me first enumerate what are the different output functions that we are going to discuss in this particular lecture. First, we will discuss this function, printf. Okay, so this is the most commonly used output function in our C programs. The second output function that we will discuss is puts. The third that we will discuss is put care. And the fourth output function that we will discuss is sprintf. Okay, these are the output functions that we will discuss. But remember, these are console output functions. That means they will give the output on the monitor. Okay, and this printf is the most commonly used output function. So let's first start about printf. But before starting printf and sprintf, so what I am saying that these two functions, printf and sprintf, they are defined in this library, studio.h. So that means if you have to use printf function in your program, you should include this library in your program. So if you didn't include this library in your program, you won't be able to use printf and sprintf functions. These two, puts and putcare, these two functions are described in conio.h, this library. So that means if you want to use these output functions, you have to use this particular library in your program. Okay, so let me discuss the first one, that is printf. So let's first discuss. So this one we will discuss, printf, the first one. This is the most important function, or we can say the most commonly used function, printf. Okay, let me discuss about this function. As I said, the first thing that I said is that it is an output
function. What does that mean? Its only job is to provide output on the screen, and it is not doing any job. But before discussing printf, you have to remember one thing, that every function returns a value, returns something. That means whenever a function is called, it returns something. You can use this something or you can simply ignore this something. It depends on you. Okay, so I am saying here that every function returns something to its caller, or we can say to the function from which it has been called. And you can use this something or you can simply ignore this something. It is on you whether you want to use it or you want to ignore it. Okay, so every function has a return value. So we have to discuss this in great detail in the functional chapter, but here I want you to know, to keep this in mind, that every function returns a value. So let's come back to printf function. So printf is an output function. That means it is used to output something on the screen. Let's see what is the syntax of printf. Syntax means, as I said, that every function has a name, okay, and it has these arguments, or we can say inputs. Arguments. And also a function has a return value. Return means, what does it return? Whether it will return an integer value, a float value, a double value, a character value, what does it return? So that return value is written here. For example, int. Int means that this function will return integer. However, when a function is called, like this. We have to write function name and provide the arguments, and it will give us the output. Okay, whatever it is, it is functionality. Printf has a syntax. The syntax of printf function is, its name is printf. Okay, and it takes following arguments. What are its arguments? The first thing that you have to remember is that printf has variable number of arguments. What does that mean? So there are some functions which have, let's suppose, only one argument. And there are some functions which have two arguments. And there are some functions which have variable number of arguments. Variable means that sometimes they may have two arguments, sometimes they may have three arguments, sometimes they may have four arguments. Okay, and these functions which have variable number of arguments, these functions are also called var functions. Or leave this here, so we don't have to discuss it here. But I am saying that there are some functions that have variable number of arguments. Variable means sometimes they may have two arguments, sometimes three arguments, sometimes four arguments. And printf is one such function that has variable number of arguments. Its first argument is always a string. First argument is always a string. So you have to remember, printf function's first argument is always a string. So we know that a string is enclosed within double quotes. So this we already know, that a string in our C programming language is enclosed within double quotes. So first argument will always be a string. What are these arguments? Second, third. For example, the first is always string. And these arguments, they vary.
we will see what are these arguments. Okay, so what I am saying, printf has variable number of arguments. Variable means it may have one argument, two argument, three argument, but you have to remember it cannot have a zero argument. It always has this first argument. What is this first argument? First argument is string. And whatever this first argument is, it prints this argument on the screen. So what I am saying, whatever this first argument is, it will print this argument on the screen. And what is this first argument? It is a string. And it will print this string on a screen. For example, let me write an example here. Printf. Now I am writing, for example, string. As I said, the first argument is string. Hello. Let's say there is only one argument. As I said, if it has printf has only one argument, that one argument will be a string. So what will this function does? When I have this function in my program, C program, this will get executed and it will print hello on the screen. This is the job of this printf function. It will print hello on the screen. Now let's say I am writing printf. This is C. So what will this do? It will print this is C. So let me write a small program that will use printf function. And the program should print this hello world. Hello world. This is my first C program. So this it should print. So I am saying that I want to make a program and that program should print this. So what should be the format of my program? So since I have to print this, so that means I will use which function? Printf function. And I know printf function is described in which library? Studio. Dot h. So that means this library I have to use in my program. So let me make a simple program. So since we have to use printf function, so the first part that we have to do is that we have to include studio.h in our program. So this is included. So now we know that what is the function that we have to use? Main, because every program starts with a main function. So we will write main. Okay, main, then this opening brace and opening bracket and closing bracket. Main also has arguments, but this function also has variable arguments and sometimes it has no argument. So here we are using a main that has no argument. Then main. Okay, so this is the opening. What we want in this function? In this function, we want to print. This program should print hello world. This is my first C program. So for printing, I have to use which function? Printf. And what should be the string? The string should be hello world. Full stop. This is my first C program. Then close the string and close the bracket. Last will be a semicolon. Semicolon is also called a delimiter. Okay. Then we will close the brace. This is our program. So if I run this program, if I first compile this program and then run, it will do what it will do. It will start from the main. Then it will go here. Which function is this? Printf. So it will print this on the screen. Hello world. This is my first C program. Okay. So let me go back here. So I said that printf function
its name is printf, then it has a variable number of arguments. So this is first argument, and this argument is always a string. And then we have next argument, next, it has variable number of arguments. Okay, now let's see what are these other arguments. If I simply have to print a string, I don't need these arguments. So string can be easily printed by giving only one argument to print a function, and that argument should be a string. Now let's see, if for example in my program I am using an integer a is equal to 10. Okay, I am using an integer a is equal to 10. Now for example I have integer b, so this is another integer. Now I am doing b is equal to a minus 5. A minus 5. Now let's say I want to print value of b. Print value of b. So on the screen my output should be value of b is, what is the value of b here, is 5. Value of b is 5. This should be the output on screen, this. So to have this output on the screen, which function should I use? Printf. And its first argument is always a string. The string that we want to print, what we want to print, we want to print this. We want to print value of b is 5. Okay, then I will close this. We will see what is the problem using this. For example, I am doing printf the value of b is 5. Okay, let's say this is main here, this is opening brace, and this is closing brace. Okay, let me rewrite this program. So I have rewritten this program here. So let's see what this program does, this particular program. So it will go to main, then int a. So it make a variable a, and a is equal to 10. So we are declaring a variable here, and we are also initializing it, giving it a value. So a is equal to 10. Int b. So here we are declaring a variable b, and we are not initializing it. Initializing means we are not giving it a value. And also you can see this particular is an automatic variable. Okay, so this is an automatic variable. B is equal to a minus 5. So what is a? 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. So what will be the value in b? 5. And then print f value of b is 5. So when our program completes, what will be the output? Output will be value of b is 5. This will be the output on the screen. Will this produce anything on the screen? No. This will also produce nothing on the screen. So this will also not produce anything on the screen. These are internally operations that are operating internally, but this will provide an output. Now let's say instead of 10, I have 9 here, and the remaining program is same. What will be the output outside? So in B, what is the value? Value will be a minus 5. A minus 5 will 9 minus 5. That is 4. So in B, we have 4. Okay. But our function will print. What will our function print? Value of B is 5. Why it will print value of B is 5? Because printf function, it is printing whatever is given there. So what was given here? Value of b is 5. But what is the actual value of b? Actual value of b is 4. So we want that here, instead of directly writing the value, we want here that my printf should print what is stored in b. Whatever is stored in. But if we directly write a number, it will directly print that number. But what we want here, we want that it should print the value that is stored in this variable. In this variable, which variable? B variable. So for that purpose, our printf function uses some specifiers. So I will describe what are these specifiers in detail. So it uses some specifiers. Okay. And these specifiers are also called conversion specifiers. What does that mean? Our printf function, this printf function, in this printf function, we will write the string, the whatever we want to print. We want to print value of b is, what should be printed here? It should print the value of this variable, what is stored in b. Okay, so instead of writing here, we will tell to the printf that you have to print the value of variable. So for telling this printf that you have to print the value of variable, for that we use this symbol, percent symbol. Okay, we use percent symbol. So when my printf function runs, what it will do? It will start printing. Okay, it will start printing. It will print value of b is. Now it finds this character. This is percent character. It will say that this is here. That means I have to print the value of variable. Okay, so we know that variables are of different types. For example, we can have a variable of type integer. We can have a variable of type character. We can have a variable of type float. We have different types of variables. So for every variable, for every data type, we have some symbol after this. For example, if the variable is integer, then the symbol after this is d. So for integer, the symbol is %d. So that means this %d will inform our printf function that here you have to print a variable, and that variable is an integer. Okay, now we will close it. Fine. So what our printf function does, it will do printf value. It will print value of b is. Now here we have %d. So printf, whenever it sees it, it means it has to print the value of an integer variable. Integer variable. But how does this printf function knows which integer variable? Is this a, b, or something else? So we have informed printf that you have to print an integer variable, but we have not informed printf which variable. So for that, we write an argument here. The next argument will say which variable you have to print. So which variable we have to print here? We have to print b. So we will write b here. Okay. So what is my printf going to do? It will do. So when printf function is executed, it will do. It will print value of b is. Value of b is %d. It will see that I have to print an integer. But which integer? It will go outside this string. So outside this string, what is the variable? Variable is b. B means that here it has to print the value of b. So what is the value of b? Value of b is 4. It will print 4. Okay. Now, for example, if I have to do this, if I want that my program should print value of a is equal to, so what is the value of a here? 9 and comma value of b is equal to, what is the value of b? 4. So it should print this. So how should I use printf function? I should use like this. So this is the entire text I want to print. So this entire text should be in this string. So I will write printf value of a is equal to. What is the value of a? 9. So we want to print here value of a. Okay, so that means my printf function should print here value of a. So what is a? A is an integer. So we will say it print an integer here. Okay, comma, and then value of b is equal to. So here we want to print the value of b. B is also an integer. So we will do percent d. So here we are saying value of a is equal to percent d. Percent d means that here it has to print an integer. But which integer? A integer. So we have to inform printf also which integer you have to print. So that is provided after this string. So here it has to print value of a, variable a. Okay. And next here it has to print value of b, and then close this. So now let's see what my printf function does. It will do value of a is, here my printf function has saw this special character. So it will get the information that here I have to print the value of variable. But which variable? So it will go outside this string. So this is string. It will go outside string. So this is the first conversion specifier. First. So it will here also in these arguments. So these arguments are actually variables. So this is variable A and this is variable B. So it will go outside these and it will print the first variable, value of first variable. So what is first variable? A. What is value stored in A? 9. So it will print 9, comma. Then it will start again this value of B is equal to, again it saw a convergence specifier. Convergence specifier means here it has to print the value of a variable. So which variable? So this is the second convergence specifier. So here it was first, this is second. So now here it will go in these variables and it will find the second. Who is the second? B is the second. So it will print the value of B. What is the value of B? 4. Okay. So that means our printf function. So let me write the structure of printf function. So printf function, its input is the string, format string it is called, format string, the string that we want to print. And then, so string is closed in these double quotes, then comma, list of variables, and then closing this. So for example, variable 1, comma, variable 2, comma, variable 3. So how many variables will be here? So the number of variables here is determined by the number of convergence specifiers in the string. Convergence specifiers in the string. So as I said, whenever we have an integer, we have to print an integer. What is a convergence specifier? Percent d. Now let's say I have to print a character. So for character, convergence specifier is percent c. For float, convergence specifier is percent f. For string, for printing a string, convergence specifier is percent s. For unsigned, short unsigned, for example, short unsigned, conversion specifier is %u. For long unsigned integer, conversion specifier is %lu. So you don't have to remember, you will memorize these itself when you write different types of programs. Okay, for double will be a long float, so it will be %lf. So these are the most commonly used conversion specifiers. So let me give some of the examples so that you are able to get the printf function correctly. For example, let's say let's take a main program. So since in our main program we have to use which function? Printf function. Okay, so we will use this library, studio.h. So you have to remember this. For using printf function, we have to use this library, studio.h. Okay, so now our main program starts. So let's say int a is equal to 5, int b is equal to 6, float c comma d is equal to 6.5, c is equal to a plus b plus d. Now I am writing printf. A is equal to %d, comma b is equal to %d, comma c is equal to %f, comma d is equal to %f. This is closing, then a comma b comma c comma d. So this ends. So here, now let's see this program. So here, so the program is starting at main. So a is an integer. What is the value in a? A is 5. B is also an integer. It is 6. So c is a float, but we have not given any value to a float. Also, we can declare multiple variables in a same line by separating these variables using comma. So here I am declaring variable c, comma, then variable d. D will also be a float, but I am initializing D. D is equal to 6.5. So D is 6.5. Then here I am doing C is equal to A plus B plus D. So A is 5 plus 6 plus 6.5. That will be 17.5. So what is value in C? C we have 17.5. Now let's say I am doing this. Print F. So up to this, in my C, what will be the value? 17.5. Will there be anything on the screen? No. Because we have not used printf function. Now here we are using printf function. So it will start printing. What will it print? It will print. So first it will start from the double quotes. First is A. It will write A is equal to. What is A is equal to? %d. So that means here conversion specifier is %d. That means we have to print here. What we have to print? An integer. So for getting the value of integer, we have to go outside this string and see the list of variables. So this is the list of variables. How many? 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see here also in this string how many specifiers we are using. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So this is the first one. So that means we have to take the value of first one. What is A? A is 5. It will print A is equal to 5. Then comma, B is equal to, again %d. So it will print B. That is 6. Then C is equal to %f. %f means it has to print a float. Okay, float. So it will go here. So this is the third one. So third one is C. It will print the value of C. Value of C will be 17.5. Then D is equal to %f. So here D is 6.5. So it will print like this. So this is how actually our printf is working. So in a speed of 6.5, or I'm saying here 17.5, it is printing. It will print, I have given here an example that it will print 17.5. In a state, it will print 17.5. In some of the compilers, it will print like this. And also here, when we have D, it will compile 6.500. By default, when we have a floating point, so this is floating point and this is floating point, and when we are printing a floating point, it will print total 8 digits. So in some of the compilers, it is doing like this. Here also it will print total 8 digits. So it will be 17.5 and the remaining digits will be zeros. Okay. So what in most of the compilers, what is happening? So for example, whenever we are printing something, so basically our screen is divided into different parts. Okay, let's say this is our screen. So for example, this is our screen, this portion. Let's say this is our screen. Fine. So our screen, so this is complete computer screen, it is divided into following sub parts. So this is part one of the screen, this is second part, this is third part, this is fourth part. Let me show here only four part, and each part can accommodate 8 digits. So 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Likewise this one also 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. And this also, this also. So that means a screen is divided into columns. So these are columns. And each column, in each column, we can print one digit. So these are 8 columns. They are together reserved for one, printing one number. So what I mean to say here, I will give it with the help of an example. Let's say I am writing a program. Let's say this is my program, hash include studio.h, then main, we have main program. So I said that every function has a return value. So I am not writing any return value here. Okay, but whenever we are writing a program, we have to write a return value here. So if we are not writing a return value here, it by default assumes that this main function returns integer. Returns integer. So if we are not writing anything here. Okay. So if I write int, int means that this function will return integer. However, if I didn't write anything, it also means it will return integer. Now if you are saying that my function should return nothing, okay, it should not return anything, so you have to write void. Void is a special data type that means nothing. So we will discuss it in detail, this void and the return type of functions, but you have to keep this in mind that every function has a return value. So I am writing main, and then we have, let's say, int a is equal to 235. So this is integer a. Now float b is equal to 54.2. okay, now I am doing printf a is equal to %d / n, b is equal to %f, and then so this %d, for this %d we have to print variable a, and for this %f we have to print variable b, and then close the function. Now for example, if I have written nothing here, so nothing means this function should return integer. So last should be return some integer. You can write any integer here. Let's say I am writing 0. So we have to understand what is the meaning of return, and that will be discussed in our subsequent lectures. But here you have to understand that every function returns one value. And if we are writing nothing here, that means this function should return an integer. And we are returning 0. 0 is an integer. Now, if I write void, void means that it won't return anything. Then there is no need to write this. You will simply write the closing bracket. Okay. So this, some compilers will give a message that you have to return something whenever we are not writing anything here. But some compilers ignore that warning. But it is better to return integer when you are saying that main will return an integer. However, if you are saying that main will return void, then you don't have to write this statement. So let's see what this function is going to do, this particular. So A is an integer variable. It is getting value 235. B is a float variable. It is getting 54.2. Now we are doing printf. Printf A is equal to, so this will print on screen, A is equal to percent %d. Percent %d means it has to print integer. So which value it should print? A. Okay. A is an integer, so it will print 235. Okay. So this part is completed. Now it is backslash n. What is the meaning of backslash n? This is an backslash character, or we can say it is also called an escape character. We have already discussed it in our previous lecture, what is a backslash character. So the meaning of this character, it means that go to a new line. So we are writing in this line, so now we will move to the next line. This means go to new line. Okay, so in new line, B is equal to percent %f. What is percent %f? Percent %f is this one, second one. It means print float. So which print? B. B is float. So it will print 54.2. Now, as I said, the screen has, or we can say the float is always, we print 8 digits. By default, we print 8. So this is used in case of some compilers. So it will print 54.20000. Now, for example, you have different numbers. Okay. Let's say you have one number is 2, 3, 5, 6. Another number is 3, 2, 8. Another number is 42. Let's say you want that your number should get printed like this. 2, 3, 5, 6, then 3, 2, 8. 3, 2, 8, then 42. 4. Okay, in this manner, how will you print that? So let's say int A is equal to 235, int B is equal to 328, and int C is equal to 42. Now, if you did print f A is equal to percent %d and then backslash n, why? Because we want to print it in new line. Okay, B is equal to now let's say you have 3 digits 2, 3, 4, 5, another is 3, 2, 8, another is 42, and you want to print these 3 on the screen like this. Let's say A is equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, then B is equal to 3, 2, 8, okay, and then C is equal to 42. Or we can say, let's not write A, B, C. Let's say you want to do 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 2, 8, 42. Or we can say write justified. How will you print that? Okay, so let's say this is A, integer A, this is B, this is C, int A, int B, and int C. So for printing, we know that what function we have to write, printf. So we have to print these 3 numbers in three different lines, 1, 2, 3. In the first line, we should print 2, 3, 4, 5. So we will write percent D. So sorry, we have to start double quotes. So percent D, okay? Percent D means that we have to print the first one, integer. Then we have to move to next line. So for moving to next line, we will write backslash N. Then in the next line, we have print 3 to 8. 3 to 8 is also an integer, so we will do percent D. Then again next line, then 42. 42 is percent D. So this is closing. So A, B, and C, these are the variables. So let's see how this printf function works. This particular function. Let's see how it is working. So what it will do, it will see this. Percent D, that means I have to print an integer. So which integer? The first one. First one is A. A is 2, 3, 5, 4. 2, 3, 4, 5. It will print 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, backslash N. Backslash N means move to the next line. So you know, I have already said that this entire screen is divided into 8 digits. Or we can say 8 columns. The next 8 column. The next 8 column. So we always start from the first one. So it will be 2, 3, 4, 5. Now the next line. Next line we have to print percent D. Percent D is B. So we have to print 3 to 8. So it will print 3 to 8. Then after that again new line. New line means move to the next line. So percent D. Which one? C. C is 42. So it will print 40. Okay, but we wanted in this manner. However, we are getting in a different manner. So how will we achieve this kind of formatting using printf? Okay, so we have to see how we will use printf to have this kind of formatting. This kind of formatting. For that particular case, we have some other specifiers. Okay, we have some other specifiers. So like our conversion specifiers, for example, percent D. Percent D means we have to print an integer. Likewise, percent F. Percent F means we have to print a floating point number. Okay. But please, there is one small mistake here. So I said that a screen is divided into 8 parts. Instead, it is divided into 10 parts. So not we have 10 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then again 10 parts. Previously, I said only 8 parts. But actually, in most of the cases, it is divided into 10 parts. So let's come here again. So percent D specifier means an integer. Percent F means a floating point. Percent C means a character. Okay. So what these specifiers are doing, these additional specifiers, or these are also called width specifiers. These width specifiers, they say what should be the width of the variable that we want to print using a percent specifier. So what does this mean? So this is our specifier, and this specifier, using this specifier, we are printing some variable. So these specifiers, width specifiers, say, so if I want to display this variable, which is denoted by this specifier, denoted by the specifier means this variable or this variable. So what should be the width of this particular variable? Okay, what should be the width that I want to print? Let's say, let me make you understand with the help of an example. So, for example, and you have to remember, let's take in case of integers. Integers means which are printed using percent D. So, we can use width specifiers with these specifiers, with integer specifier. And these width specifiers, they are given here. Then will be D. Okay. So, here, whatever we are printing here, that will give us the width of an integer to be printed. To be printed. So, what does that mean? For example, let's say int A is equal to 54. Int A is equal to 54. Let's say I am doing printf, I will write different statements. Printf A is equal to percent D backslash N. Then A. Okay. Then the next printf A is equal to percent 2D backslash N. A. So printf A is equal to percent 4D backslash N A. Printf A is equal to percent 60 backslash N. So let's see what these different printfs will print. Let's first go to this one, printf. It will print. So it will start from this a is equal to percent d. Percent d means I have to print an integer. Which one? Which integer? A integer. So it is 54. It will print 50. Now, so after this, we have backslash n. Backslash n means go to next line. Now in the next line, we have to do printf a is equal to. So a is equal to percent. So this is also percent D, but before D we have 2. It means that we have to print integer, but the length of integer should be 2. Length of integer should be 2. Now let's first see what is this integer. Integer is A, 54. That means we have to print 54 and its width should be 2. Okay. So since its width is 2, it will print 54. So 1 and 2, width means how many digits. Okay. So here if you see in the previous case, width was 1. 1 means that integer should have only 1 width. But here integer has what width? By default it has 2 widths. So if it is width given here is less than the actual width, then this is ignored. Okay. It is printed like this. So here 2 means that width should be 2. Now the third is, so here we have backslash n, so that means we have to move to next line. Next line, in next line we have to print a is equal to percent 4d. It is saying we have to print an integer, but the width of that integer should be 4. And which integer we have to print? A. So what is a? A is basically 54. It is only 2. Okay. But we are saying here that we have to print it with width 4. So 2 width is already available there. So how many are remaining? 2. So we will leave 2 spaces vacant here. First space and second space. And then in the third space we will print 5. And in the fourth space we will print 4. So it will do like this. 54. First 2 will be vacant. Now this is saying A is equal to percent 6D. So what should be the length? 6. And what we have to print? A. But A has only 2. So first 4 will be vacant. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we will print 5 and 6. So this is how width specifiers are used with the integers. Okay. So what I am saying, So I am saying a width integer, width specifier, for example, percent xd. It says that whatever integer we have to print, its length should be x. However, so there are two cases. First case is if x is less than width of integer, then x is neglected. So we don't take care of the x. Second, if x is greater than width of integer, then first x minus width spaces are left vacant. Okay, so this is how width specifier is used in case of integers. So now our example was that we should print in this manner. Okay, so let's see how we will print in this manner. So if you can see, the length of this is 4, this is 3, and this is 2. So what we are going to do, we will keep the length of each as 4. This also 4, this also 4, and this also 4. So length of everyone should be 4. So here the first one will remain vacant because length is 3. So here 2 will remain vacant. So let's see how we will print it. So it is A, this one is A, this one is B, this one is C. So how you are going to write the print statements? Printf So we will do A is equal to %4d a, so and backslash n here. Backslash n means start printing from next line. Printf b is equal to %4d backslash n b, then printf c is equal to %4d backslash n c. Now let's see, let's use the printf statements. So first printf statement, it is doing a is equal to %4d, so it should print an integer. Which integer? A integer. What is an a? 2, 3, 4, 5. So what should be the length? It is saying that length should be 4, and it also has length 4, so it will print 2, 3, 4, 5. Then next is, so we have to go to new line. B is equal to %4db. Now we have to print integer b. So what is integer b? 3, 2, 8. But it is saying its length should be 4. But actual length is 3. So first one should be vacant. And then we will print 3, 2, 8. Then the next one. C is equal to %4d. Again it is showing what should be the length? 4. And what we have to print? C. What is C? 42. So leave first two places, it should be 42. So this is how, using a width specifier, we can format the numbers while printing. So it is here, if you see that it is doing 42. So basically it is doing right justification. Now let's say if we are saying that the number should have width 4. For example, it should have 4 width. But it should start from the left and the next 2 should be vacant. So C should be 42 and these 2 should be vacant. Okay, then for less left justification, instead of plus 4, I have to write minus here. So minus will say that do the left justification. So what does that mean? For example, if I am doing printf, c is equal to percent minus 4d, okay? Then I am writing something, hello. Okay, then close, then C. Let's see what is this printf statement doing. Printf, it is saying C is equal to percent d or percent 4d. So we have to print which? An integer. Which integer? C integer. What is C? C is 42. And what should be the length? Its length should be 4. But negative science says that it should be left justified. So what does that mean? So it means that we have to write four places, at four places. The length should be 4. But we should start from the first place. And these two places will remain vacant. Now, after these two places, what is there? Hello. After this, we will write hello. So this is what will be printed on the screen. Okay. So this is how width specifier is used in case of integers. So if we have percent xd, this x specifies the width. Now width specifier is also used in case of floats. Okay, in case of floats. So floats means that percent f. So width specifier is also used here. So in case of floats, width specifier is used in following manner. So we have percent x dot y then f. So this x specifies that total width should be x. But after decimal, we should have only y. So what does this mean? For example, if I am doing a is equal to float a is equal to 2.54. So now if I am doing printf a is equal to percent f backslash n a. Now another statement is percent f a is equal to percent 3.2 backslash n a. Sorry, percent 32 f. It is print f a is equal to percent 5.2f. Now let's see what these statements will do. So this is saying print f a is equal to, so a is equal to percent f. Percent f means print the float. Which float? A float. A is 2.54. By default it will print how many? 10. So I was previously saying only 8, but basically it is 10. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now here print f a is equal to 3.2f. It is saying that only print how many? So I should print a floating point number a, but its width should be 3. And after decimal, I should have only 2. So total width should be 3. Okay, total width should be 3. So what is the width of this? Width is 1, 2 and 3. And after decimal there are 2. So it will simply write 2.54. Now the third one. Third one is saying that total width should be 5. And after decimal we should have 2. So after decimal we have 2. And total width should be 5. But total width here is only 3. So the remaining two will remain vacant. The first and second will remain vacant. So from here it will start sorry, yes, first and second, this one and this one. So here it is 2.54. So this is how width specifier is used in case of printing floating point numbers. Okay, so we completed how printf function is used, how specifiers are used, both the what I'm saying, the width specifiers and convergence specifiers. Moreover, we said that in printf, this escape character, this means move to new line. New line. And there are many other characters. For example, backslash t. T says go to the next tab. Next tab, push the tab and start printing from next tab. And likewise, I have also discussed what is the meaning of R, what is the meaning of V. So we have already discussed these characters. So whenever these characters come in the printf, it will do the functionality of these characters, these special characters. These are also called backslash characters or we also called these as escape characters. So there was another character, this backslash and double colon. So what is the use of this character? For example, let's say you want to print hello, hello, Jack. You want to print this. This. How will you print this? This particular. So somebody will say, I will do printf and then hello, then double quotes, Jack. So this one will get printed and this is the closing of this one and then this. Somebody will say that this will print hello, Jack, but it won't print this. Why? Because when my printf function is getting executed, first is closing, first is opening these quotes. So it will start printing from that position up to that position where it will find a closing brace, okay, or closing quotes. So closing quotes are here only, not here. Also, these closing and opening, they have spatial meaning. Spatial meaning in case of printf. So if you use these spatial meaning characters, not only these spatial meaning, this also has a spatial meaning, this single quote. Okay, so these single quotes cannot be directly printed, but I want that this should be printed as well. To print these special characters as well, so before these special characters, you have to write a backslash. And here also you have to write a backslash. Okay, so what my printf is going to do now, it will find these, then it will print hello. Then it will see this backslash. It is also called escape. So it will see the next character. The next character is double quotes. So whatever is double quotes, it will print that. And then Jack. Then again, after we have backslash, backslash, it will see the next. Next digit is double quotes. It will close this. Then we have this closing. So it means it is ended. Okay. So this is how double quotes are printed in case of printf. So you have to take use of backslash. So backslash this, it will print double quotes, and backslash this will print single quote. Backslash this, it will print a single slash, this backslash. So this is how backslash is used. So with this, we complete the discussion about printf. We complete the discussion about the type modifiers and width modifiers. Okay, so the printf function is completed. Now we can use printf without any hesitation. Okay, but there are some other output functions as well. Okay, as I said, there are other output functions, for example, sprintf, puts, putchar. And apart from the output functions, those output functions, we have input functions as well. So the discussion about the remaining output functions and input functions we will continue the discussion in the next lecture. So let's meet in the next lecture. Till then, goodbye.